Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Coming to you live from the outskirts of the internet, this is the Gaming Saloon for December 11th, 2015, with your host, Peacebreaker2448, and Rapid Epsilon.
Hi. We're coming to you live from a new office. No, I'm kidding. I changed how stuff is being displayed video-wise.
Well, that's fun.
It looks better, in my opinion.
Well, we're always trying to improve things around here, because fuck it, might as well just improve it on our own terms. Also, dashboard didn't get updated. Shit. Fuck, we forgot about that.
Unprofessional. At best.
It's updated.
Leave also, it to us to screw up stuff.
Yep.
I'm gonna do a new tweet.
Okay, I'll just retweet it. Because I was working on that, and I'm like, God, fuck it, you'll do it. That's the second time in a row we've done that.
Yep!
We need to start double-checking the dashboard. Anyway. So... this is kind of the last EGS of 2015.
Is it?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. Whoa.
Because the last Rampant Gaming for 2015 is next week, and then all of our pre-recorded Christmas special stuff goes out the week after, so we don't have a EGS until literally the first day of 2016.
Wow. I didn't think about that.
Well, I'm saving the big topic thing for that time. So I'm like, you know what? I'll save it for then. Because we got plenty to talk about this week.
And by plenty, you mean a grand total of 5 articles.
Well, 2 of those are bucket articles. Because one of them is the VGA Awards, the other is PlayStation Experience. Yeah, keep that in mind. So, yeah. Anyway, before we get started in all the articles stuff from the last couple weeks, anything interesting you've been playing?
Picked up Super Mario World again. Realized I still suck at that, even after playing Super Mario Maker and doing decent at it.
Well, that's because I think all of the physics in the Mario Maker games are off New Super Mario Brothers.
Not really.
Oh, that's something I thought I heard that off like a Did You Know. That all the physics were actually off the new Super Mario stuff.
I mean, you can tell that a lot of that's implemented in there, but I wouldn't say completely. Because, like, if you're doing a Super Mario Brothers one, it feels like the original. It does not feel like it's something new with a skin slapped on it kind of deal.
Yeah.
So I could see it at least being influenced, but not completely.
Okay. I'll tell you, it's been dick in, I'll be honest. like the last 2 weeks have involved finals for me, so I've been busy the last couple weeks.
Outside of Vegas League.
Yeah.
And
yeah.
Payday 2.
Yeah. And then my first shot at recording Radiant Dawn, I'm going to re-record the entire first episode.
That bad?
Not really, I just want to do it over again, now that I've gotten a feel for it. I don't think it turned out bad, it was just like, I want to redo it, because I want to see if I can get a better shot at it. And not fuck up twice over the course of the 2 chapters.
Make a suggestion?
What?
Don't scrap what you've already got until you've done it again.
I haven't, to be honest. Mostly because I haven't got to sit down and actually try to re-record Radiant Dawn.
Well, the reason I say that is because I know my luck is I would think, I'm going to do it again, I'll do it better. And then do it worse.
Oh. here's the weird thing. There's a lot less dialogue I have to do in Radiant Dawn. Because you know those, like, chapter introduction ones that are like, last time on Fire Emblem Path of Radiance? Like, yeah. Those kind of cutscenes? Yeah, those are voiced now, so I don't have to do them. I'm like, yes! More dialogue I don't have to do! Woo!
Well, that benefits.
Yeah, I don't have to do the last time on Fire Emblem Path of Radiance. I just have to go, hey, I just have to do all the voices for all the fucking characters.
If only there was an easy way of going about doing that.
There's not.
I mean, and in terms of having others. But there's not.
Yeah, it's just like, yes, I would have to literally give you a script to work off of. And that doubles the amount of work I want to put in a Radiant Dawn. Just bear in mind, doubling that script, anytime I fuck up, we all have to do the dialogue again. All of us have to do the dialogue again. None of us want to do that, I would assume. Because I'm willing to suffer through doing repeating dialogue multiple times. I don't think you and Glock would be. Because it gets obnoxious after a while. All it takes is one bad fluke, and I'm just like, I'm done. I can't do anything. Yeah, that's been the short and long of my playtime recently. Like, I hopped on and got the anniversary stuff for SWTOR. And that was it on my own time. Because the last couple weeks have been finals, moving back in, because I moved out of the dorm room, back home to January 19th or something like that. Like, whenever the spring semester starts back for the college, so I've got all the time at home now to do stuff, which I plan on doing Radiant Dawn and playing more Persona 3 FPS, because I want to play more of that on my own time now. So I haven't gone back to the game, and I want to go back to the goddamn game, damn it. That's like the priority one of my, I want to complete this game before at some point in the near future. Like, that's on the backlog list, top priority for me, so. I mean, hell, I got the smuggler story complete to original completion. Like, my smuggler is through the main story of SWTOR before the expansions came out, so.
Oh, wow.
Because I even have the notification like, hey, you completed the original story for Smuggler. Now you move on to Hutt Cartel in Shadow Revan for me, along with whatever's like in between all that stuff. So like, I can work on that on my own time if I want to. Yeah. I haven't really watched anything special gaming wise. Like, I watched the live commentary of PlayStation Experience, and I had TweetDeck up when we were recording TGSR when the BGAs were on. But that was it. Like, here's the thing, Gerard doing a like 5 month long stream of Xenoblade Chronicles 3D, I'm like, cool! I'm not really that interested because I've already seen someone play Xenoblade Chronicles through to completion. Because I watched Chuck and Condre's original Let's Play of that game.
Oh, wow.
So I'm like, yeah, I know the entire story of Xenoblade Chronicles. I'm not that interested. Like, I might check in every now and again, but I'm like, meh. Not priority for me. Like, it's cool and all, but, eh. Watched a little bit of the All-Stars for League last night, before I got off. It's cool. They have a 5v5 and a 1v1 tournament. The thing is, it's, Team Fire versus Team Ice, so three teams of, All-Stars versus another three teams of All-Stars. So So I was like, I think it's NA, someone else and someone else versus, like, EU, someone else and someone else. I think they're just doing a whole bunch of stuff. I think they just did a marksman mode match. So it's like all marksmen.
Ooh.
And I'm like, you know what? I might check in All-Stars for more All-Stars content if they're doing random shit like this. And it is all pro players, so. It would be nice to see some like fun, interesting, and kind of dumb things they do. That's been it for me gaming wise. A new trailer came out for Battle Royale War Genesis. It was like a 5-minute long trailer. It looks like they're doing some new moves for some of the characters. Like Flame Dragon Wizard has a new move. But I don't know. I kind of want to wait and see when it gets released and gets a full playthrough of it, or at least some gameplay of it, to see how much has changed. Because I'm not immediately buying in, especially with like, hey, a bunch of these people are coming back voicing these roles, and I'm like, I don't bite on that, even if it's for characters I like, because it's like Hibiki comes back for this game. And I'm like, cool. I'm not buying this game for returning actors. I'm buying this game because I wanted a cool Kamen Rider video game to play. And it needs good gameplay for me to care. Because I can't exactly do story with this game. Because, you know, language barrier. Plus, it looks so much like Super Hero Taizen G, but I'm like, oh, this is a bad connection to have.
Yeah, I agree with you on that statement.
Yeah. Which to say, like, the story is just coming from the same idea GP's story came from, where it's just, hey, we're gonna fuck with the history of Kamen Rider so Kamen Riders don't exist. And I'm like, okay. In this case, it's more... All of the main writers apparently got defeated in their first episode battles, so they never got to go on and have their career or have their seasons happen. Therefore, Evil won. Because that's the gimmick levels, is you go back and do the first episodes of each of the writers.
Huh.
And then there's all that, like, we're getting Takeshi Hongo, like, untransformed fighting, and then the ability to transform mid-battle, and I'm like, that's cool! It also looks ugly as fuck. It doesn't look that good. Like, am I the only one that's not blind to this, and the fact that, like, that doesn't look that good. Like, at all. Like, it'd be cool if they did this for everyone, but it still wouldn't look that good. Like, you get points up and points down for that. Yeah. Smash Direct is Tuesday, and we may or may not do something either Tuesday night or somewhere between that and end of the year for the Smash Direct. All depends. Yeah, because we had the announcement, I think, like 2 days ago that Smash Direct was Tuesday. And I'm like, well, it's a little late for us to be doing it on here, so we might do a mini TGS for it. Just so we can either praise it or gripe about it because someone didn't get in.
Probably gripe about it.
To be honest, I'm with, I think it was one of the Amiibo fan sites had each one of their writers pick somebody they wanted in the wanted for DLC. And the first person was like, I'm going to pick this person because I honestly don't have any other options. And I didn't realize I wanted this character before until like a month ago. It was Linkle. And I'm like, I'm in your camp where I'm like, I don't know who the fuck I want because I just don't know. Like, this is a fairly complete roster as is. Like, anyone I think we get at this point is just icing on the cake.
Yeah.
Like, as much as I want another Fire Emblem character, I don't have a good choice. Because I'm like, I assume main character. Since Lin's an assist trophy, that can't happen. So, Micaiah, because I have no other options. And even then, I'm like, eh. Like, I would totally like someone else, but I don't think anyone besides a main character from a Fire Emblem game is going to get in the Smash. So I can't go to the extended roster. Like, some of the other bounty hunters from Metroid would be cool, but I don't know if that's going to be popular enough to get in.
Yeah.
Because we may or may not get Ridley. Even though, did you see the bingo card I retweeted?
Don't think so, actually.
Oh, I retweeted a bingo card that was a bit glorious. Let me grab the link real quick. Oh, God. That's a bit on the big side. Might have to zoom out for this one. That's the bingo card I retweeted.
Well, you do know it says large at the end of it, right?
I didn't know it was fucking large.
Well, it says large.
I didn't see that until after I clicked on it. Not Ridley. Fucking 3x3 square free space.
Not Ridley free space.
He's too big. But I'm like looking at that, and by the way, that's 3 Smashified artworks? Because I believe that Ridley, isn't it? Or not Ridley, the K. Rules of Smashified. I knew that Diddy, that Dixie's a Smashified.
Huh.
And I think the Splatoon one's Smashified.
No, that's... No.
Oh,
I
it's
don't think that one is. I think that's just the default one.
Oh, okay. I know the rest of them aren't. But yeah, honestly, like, all those characters, those are all completely legitimate options. So I'm like, someone out of this bunch, because you know what? It'd be cool. And I got no one else, so have fun.
You know what? Out of this bunch, we already know one of them.
Shovel Knight?
Yeah.
I'm willing to put money on Shovel Knight. If Shovel Knight's not in, I will honestly be surprised.
If Shovel Knight's not in, they have some explaining to do.
Yeah, I'm like, if that's the case, I'm like, then why was Shovel Knight given an amiibo?
Like, number I know one, you want to do a... Number two, why was at one point Shovel Knight's amiibo said that it was compatible with Smash?
And three, how the fuck are you going to explain why one of the... an indie game that you're giving a full retail release to on your console and your portable device not being put in Smash.
Yeah.
Because bear in mind, Shovel Knight's getting a full retail release on store shelves for the Wii U. That was not done for any other platform it was on, I don't think. Like, that's huge.
Question?
What?
Top left, that's from Chibi Robo, isn't it?
Yep, that's Chibi Robo.
Is that not one of the assist trophies?
Chibi Robo is not an assist trophy, but he does have an amiibo.
Huh.
Yeah, he does have an amiibo for his game.
Out of all this, you know the one that I wanted the most?
What?
And I bet you can guess.
Banjo-Kazooie?
Uh-huh.
Yeah, that's a long shot, but I'm willing to believe in the dream.
Not as long of a shot as one might think.
True, but it's still a bit of a dream.
I saw something where Phil Spencer had said that he'd love to do more stuff with Nintendo, like what they did with Minecraft.
Yeah.
So there, that could open up the doorway for that one.
Yeah, that's I think that's the entire reason Banjo-Kazooie's even in the running, is because of those comments from Phil Spencer. Because otherwise, I don't think anyone would even remotely have a conversation with Banjo-Kazooie about being in Smash. But because Phil Spencer was A-okay with it, yeah, people are willing to bite. Willing to believe in that dream.
The only thing is, if they did that, what is Nintendo giving back to Microsoft at that point?
I don't know.
Because, okay, you think about it. Microsoft threw Nintendo a bone, gave it Minecraft. What are we going to get from Nintendo to Microsoft out of this transaction? And that's going to be the same with that. That's that question that's in my head, and it's like, I don't know. Because what does Nintendo really have that it can part ways with, even the least little bit, just to satisfy people?
A higher percentage on the Minecraft sales for Wii U?
True. But what Minecraft would it benefit out of Banjo-Kazooie?
It essentially pays for Banjo-Kazooie being in Smash. That's Nintendo's way of paying for it. It's like, we get Banjo-Kazooie to be put in Smash, and we'll give you more money off the sales of you. Deal? Like, there's a money transaction in there, flat out. I don't think there's anything else being traded.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You know, that could be the other reason why they kind of held back on Minecraft for Wii U.
Nintendo wanted something out of the deal?
No.
Oh.
Could be a case of they wanted to kind of push that closer to the Smash Direct.
Probably.
Look, that got announced, what, about a week and a half before we found out when the Smash Direct was going to be?
It got announced this past Monday, I think. It was either this Monday or last Monday.
Then.
Yeah, it was like this Monday or last Monday, and I'm like, it was super close.
I mean, that's kind of one of those I'm like, well... That seems to be swept under a rug on purpose, especially seeing as how everyone knew that it was coming.
Mm-hmm. Plus, it's like a 6-year-old game getting ported. Not exactly big news as they were hyping it up to be.
But seeing as how they've went on record saying that while inventory management on the gamepad's not there at launch, they're willing to work on improving it.
Yeah, that's what I was about to say. They even left that out. I'm like, what the fuck? That's the obvious thing.
Okay, but something that people are also not realizing, and I didn't even know it, apparently you can hook a USB keyboard up to a Wii U. Because Minecraft for Wii U is going to support that to communicate with other players.
Ooh.
I didn't know that was a thing.
That's neat.
I was like, okay, you can do that. Huh.
Yeah. Well, we've got a lot in store if we ever do something on the Smash Direct when it comes out next Tuesday. I'll repeat what I've said before, what I've said twice before now, I think, on several different recordings. I think we're going to get four characters. And four characters plus Cloud, and I think at this point Cloud's going to be coming out after the Direct. Just be like, oh yeah, Cloud's out. Happy Christmas, everybody.
I don't think after the Direct.
What, you think they'll release it on Christmas?
I think they're gonna do something very stupid and probably announce it at the beginning.
Just announce Cloud is like, oh yeah, he's available on the eShop right now. By the way, we still have more information, so...
Like, I could completely see them being like, okay, Cloud's on the eShop, but anyhow, here's what we're doing. Just kind of make a quick reference and keep plowing right through it.
Yeah, because be honest, like, there's no, absolutely no reason for Cloud to come out any later than he is, than, like, after the Direct. Or anytime, sometime very quickly after Direct, or even, like, before the end of the year. Because he's done. Like, that trailer shows he's done. His stage is done. Nintendo doesn't show off shit like that and not go, yeah, it's done. Because when they showed off Mewtwo, they just showed off, like, a in-progress model. And that was it. That was all they showed off of Mewtwo when they originally announced him.
You know, you're right.
Nintendo does not show off shit and not release it. If they have intentions. So Cloud and Midgar are done. And they will release... before the end of the year.
I think, though, Cloud will be out Tuesday. It's a matter of when Tuesday.
Yeah, my God. Oh, God. I'm just going to wait. I'm just waiting.
So I'm going to put this out there. Anyone that wants to buy anything off the eShop, you better do it before Tuesday.
Yeah.
Because you won't get to until Thursday.
Yeah, eShop gonna be broke for like half the week next week. There is no getting around it. People will be buying Cloud in droves and fighting to buy Cloud in droves.
This is gonna be a repeat of E3. That's all this is gonna be. Of course, I think. I'm not 100%, but I think I saw something saying that both the Wii U and the 3DS were going to have maintenance, but it wasn't going to be something that anyone would really notice.
Mm-hmm.
So, and I'm wanting to say it said Monday, but I can't swear to that. I got to find it again.
Yeah, I was hearing something about that in the stream I hopped in, that maintenance was going to be this weekend. For 3DS and Wii U, and that's exactly what happened last time for the last Smash Direct we had during E3, or like we're to kick off the E3 week. So I'm like, oh, is shit gonna get leaked before then? If Nintendo's not careful?
Yep.
Unless they have learned from E3 and are like, yeah, we're gonna keep a fucking tight ass lip seal on this.
10 hours of maintenance on the way for the Nintendo Network. Starting Sunday evening.
Ooh, that goes. That pushes it off into Monday morning before it's back up.
Sunday at 8 Eastern, 5 Pacific to Monday at 3 a.m. Pacific, 6 a.m. Eastern.
Oh, I bet some people being staying up all night waiting on this, being like, what the fuck's in there? What the fuck's in there? People data mine that shit all day Monday looking for something. I think people will data mine the fuck out of it to find something all day Monday.
Apparently... this is gonna go out in phases. Because the times I mentioned are the North American ones.
They're being careful.
Uh-huh.
Nintendo learned! Bravo, Nintendo. You learned. You learned not to
give them props on that one.
I think it's just because they learned from the Nintendo, from the E3 Direct of just like, oh, we gotta hide this shit because people will fucking find this and spoil the surprise of like, oh yeah, Ryu's in Smash, and Roy, and Lucas. And they're available right now because their movies are in the game. So, welp.
And another little tidbit. None of the official websites are specifying which games will be affected.
Of course they don't, because we all know which games. And they're like, nah, it's just general maintenance.
So, essentially, if you're playing Smash and you randomly get disconnected during that time frame, then guess what? You might can find some of the stuff for the new characters that are coming.
Yeah, I just expect Monday just to keep an eye on Twitter, just being like, has anyone data mined anything yet? Nope, 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 nope. Because people are going to data mine it all day Monday and all day Tuesday up to when the Direct happens.
To be fair,
praying to find something.
To be fair, while I think everyone's attention is going to be focused on Smash, I have a funny feeling they're going to be hiding some, more than likely, some bigger hidden updates for games like Mario Maker and Splatoon also.
Yeah. Because I just can see the Mario Maker ones, because it's like, oh yeah, all the Smash people are compatible with this game. Well, we're going to put that data in there.
Yeah. So there might be moments that Mario Maker will go down. Unless they planned way ahead for that, and I don't see how they could have.
Oh, and if you know if the Inklings get in Smash, then they have to hide data in there for, like, the new amiibos that are going to be coming. Because I guarantee you, they'll do another, like, amiibo for the Inklings.
Like, but you know what's bad, though?
What?
If they include the Inklings, I have a feeling it's going to be the girl Inkling. Because you tend to see that one more.
I would think...
Which is kind of odd.
Yeah. I would think they would pull a Robin and just do, like, just swap in between them. Like, maybe the main one, but they would still have the male one represented.
I'm kind of thinking that will happen. It'll be a Robin situation, but in terms of amiibo.
Yeah. Yeah, the amiibo, and I think the main Inkling will be probably female, but it will still be a Robin case. You just swap between male and female, and it's a palette swap between the two.
For the six different team colors.
Yep.
Because I think there is only six.
That might make up some colors for it. Because I think you need eight, and they would have to add two more. So you just add
not
two
necessarily.
Colors.
They could still stick to the six. Because keep in mind, that's six colors that you could, in theory, use between either the male or the female.
There's only eight costumes, even with the swap, I think.
That's what I'm saying. Male and female could have same colors at one point.
Oh, yeah, that's true, because Robin does have the same colors. Yeah, I forgot about that. I forgot about that.
Yeah, male and female Robin are original male and female Robin have same colors.
Yeah, and so do all the color swaps from there.
So in a technical sense, we could see both male and female Inkling in like blue or orange.
Mm-hmm.
And then have the others as the alternate colors.
Yeah.
Lot of possibility there.
Fucking Smash Direct. Why can't you be here sooner? Anyway. Yeah, I guess we can talk about articles now that we're done speculating for days on Smash Direct.
Speculation for days. But yes, let's get going.
Alright, kicking off with something that actually came out today. Well, yesterday, actually. But I don't think I saw it till today. XCOM 2 announced its season pass. And it's only $20. Unless you pick up the deluxe edition and you save $5. So, see, this is how you fucking do a season pass and doing editions of the game. You drop the price and make people want to buy the deluxe edition because it saves them money. Dumbasses. Also, all of this DLC, we know what it all is off the bat. that we're getting in the season pass.
Well then.
Yep. This is how you do a season pass, people. This is exactly how you do it. Anyway. The season pass, known as the reinforcement pack, cost you $20. You get 3 pieces of DLC. In spring 2016, you'll get Anarchy's Children. It'll feature additional customization options for your soldiers. Summer 2016 brings Alien Hunters DLC, which allow you to track down ruler aliens, but you also get new soldier customizations and weapons to do so. And finally, Shen's Last Gift will release also summer 2016. It'll add a completely new class, along with additional upgraded weapons and armor, more customization features, and a new mission and map.
Hmm.
And for those that pre-order the standard and deluxe editions, you will get the Resistance Warrior Pack, which includes more customization options. And a survivor of the old war recruit will show up in your barracks. See? This is how you do a season pass. You tell people what the fuck they're buying into. And look, for $20, you get these 3 DLCs. And you get a general idea of what these DLCs are going to be.
That is a smart idea.
Yeah. So, you tempted to pick up a pre-order for XCOM 2 now?
I don't know.
Well, pick up the, if you pre-order, you get an additional DLC for free. No matter what. Or you get additional customization options for free, no matter what.
I don't know.
If I have the money by then, I might pre-order XCOM 2, and I probably would just pre-order the deluxe edition, because fuck it, I'll go in on the DLC. But that's if I have the money at that point. And it beat through Steam because, you know, why not? They're doing full-on mod support for the game. So, expect XCOM 2, The Long War, the sequel, coming soon.
To a computer near you.
Yeah. Alright. I was about to say, why is this article taking forever? Alright, we ready to talk about who won what at the Game Awards?
I guess.
Alright, so there's only 2 memorable things I remember for the VGAs after this point, and that is Jeff Keighley shitting on Konami for legally barring Kojima from the event. And I think it was Troy Baker's comment about how to get in voice acting, which is wait for him and Nolan North to die. Essentially.
Huh.
Yeah. Because those two were in everything. Everything. One of them is even birds in a game. Not talking birds, just regular birds. Anyway. Here is who won what in the Game Awards this year. Witcher 3 Wild Hunt and CD Projekt Red become Game of the Year and Developer of the Year. No real surprise there. Witcher 3 was a really good game from what I've heard. Best Indie Game went to Rocket League. Well, there went Undertale winning anything.
Rocket League's good, but I mean...
Undertale is something else.
Yeah...
Best Mobile Handheld went to Lara Croft Go. Best Narrative went to Her Story. Best Score / Soundtrack went to Phantom Pain. Best Performance went to Viva Siffert from Her Story. Game for Impact went to Life is Strange. Wasn't Undertale in that category as well? Or was that something else?
Don't remember.
I forgot all who was in what.
Well, go back 2 weeks and look at that TGS and you'll find out.
Yeah. Best Shooter went to Splatoon. Action Adventure went to Phantom Pain. Role-playing Game went to Witcher Hunt. Or Witcher 3 Wild Hunt. Fighting Game went to Mortal Kombat X. Family Game went to Mario Maker. Sports Racing went to Rocket League. Multiplayer went to Splatoon. Art Direction went to Ori and the Blind Forest. Jeez. Those were all the jury-voted ones. Fan-voted, Esports Game of the Year went to Counter-Strike. Fan Creation went to Portal Stories Mel. Trending Game went to Greg Miller from formerly of IGN, I believe. He's doing his own stuff now, I think. Yeah, he's doing his own stuff now. Esports Team of the Year went to Optic Gaming. Esports Player went to Kenny S. Shrub. And Most Anticipated Game went to No Man's Sky.
Honestly, I'm impressed that Nintendo wound up walking out with 3 of them.
Yeah. 2 of them went to Splatoon. That shows you how much Splatoon has just been like, we've made money with this game. And we were originally going to make this a Mario game.
Okay, I'm not going to say that it doesn't deserve the best shooter one. But it didn't win that one because of the story. That's all I got to say to that.
Well, to be fair, look at its counterparts for best shooter. Half of them don't have the best stories either.
Yeah, but Splatoon's is a glorified tutorial. I swear that's all it is.
So are some of the other ones, let's be honest.
Like, don't get me wrong, it is a good game. I just wish they'd took a little more time on the story part of it. Because you can tell they kind of didn't put that much effort into that part of it. And that's fine, don't get me wrong, but yeah.
So yeah. I don't have that many problems with these winners. Except for like Undertale getting completely shafted, and I'm like, oh, come on.
Yeah.
Undertale deserves some love.
In all seriousness, it should have got best indie.
Yeah.
I mean, yeah, I get the hype behind Rocket League, but and I ain't even played Undertale is what it is.
Yeah. I will vouch for Undertale. I've only seen bits and pieces of it.
I've seen the game in terms of pacifist completion. Because that's what the Game Grumps did.
I've seen the genocide ending, and I've seen some of the bits of the genocide run. So.
And to have the same reaction out of both of us and seeing polar opposites of gameplay. Yeah.
Yeah, the Undertale deserves some love.
Yeah. Sucks it got shafted like it did.
Yeah. Alright. Anything else? Because honestly, I don't think there was any exclusives. Was the Batman Telltale game announced here or PlayStation Experience? I don't remember.
I
want to say it was announced here. We're getting a Batman Telltale game. And I'm like, okay.
I wanted to say it was here.
Yeah, that's the only thing I heard like exclusive-wise. Because I looked for like, well, exclusives were at Game Awards 2015, and there was like nothing I heard. But I'm like, well.
I'm thinking there goes it was here, Batman. Though.
It probably was. Wow. Well, do you remember Star Wars 1313 from a couple of E3s ago? You know that canceled game?
Yes, that canceled.
Well, yep. Apparently, it may not be completely dead. Lucasfilm head Kathleen Kennedy revealed it may not be dead. Apparently it's gold, and it's something we're spending a lot of time looking at, pouring through, discussing, and we may very well develop those things further. We definitely want to. I think referring to stuff that they have that they haven't released or just have canceled, but still have content for. So yeah, apparently Star Wars 1313 may not be completely dead. And may have a shot at coming back to life.
Well then.
Granted, it's a very small light of hope, but it's there. It's possible. I give them something more than Battlefront to go off of, because Battlefront's not doing that well anymore. Yeah, I said it. What up?
Battlefront was doing good to begin with.
I think it did well on launch, and it just it's tailed off after a while.
Oh, that depends on who you ask. If you ask EA, oh, it did wonderful on launch. If you ask GameStop, then nope.
Who am I willing to believe? The publisher that wants the game to sell, or the people who actually sold the game?
I think what the big controversy that I'm more poking at is hard copy sales. Because, yeah, one of the big uproars that came out was GameStop saying part of the reason for lack of sales is because of lack of blockbuster games the end of this season, the gaming season. I kind of agree with that. Like, yeah, most of the stuff we've gotten has not been up to par.
Yeah.
I completely see that. And of course, after GameStop blamed Battlefront and some of the other not hype games that came out late this year, that's when EA piped up and was like, oh, it's been selling good digitally.
Do you have numbers? You don't show numbers, you can't back up your argument. Well, yeah, it's been doing good. What's the numbers look like?
I'm wanting to say the words that I saw in the one article was something saying about it sold better digitally than physically.
Okay.
Okay, that don't help you any.
All right. Well, guess we can talk about the PlayStation Experience now. The big PlayStation pseudo press conference we got a week or so ago out on the West Coast. They had a whole bunch of stuff shown off, and we got a whole bunch of videos, and we can kind of pick and choose whatever we want to take a look at. All depends. I'm going to run down the list of stuff we got, and then we'll kind of come back up. Because I know one thing we're probably going to be looking at.
Which one thing?
The one thing that, of course, we're going to be looking at, because, of course, it's the only thing we haven't really gotten a chance to look at till now. A certain thing that has the number 7 in it.
Oh. The certain thing that's peeking up at the very bottom of the screen right about where my mouse is circling right now.
Yep. Anyway, we got more looks at Uncharted 4, and apparently there's dialogue options in certain parts of the game.
Huh.
Yep. We got our first actual gameplay trailer for Final Fantasy VII Remake. We'll get to Final Fantasy VII, some other stuff about Final Fantasy VII here in a bit, but yeah.
Yeah, some not so good things.
Yeah. Got the reveal of the next Black Ops backpack. Along with a trailer announcing the Call of Duty Esports World League stuff. We got Toby, a new PlayStation 4 exclusive Battleborn character. He's a penguin driving a mech suit. We got the reveal of Bang, another new character, or the last launch character for Street Fighter V, and also the reveal of the we already knew about this, but we're going to talk, but we're going to announce this anyway. Hey, here's the six additional characters coming next year as DLC, which we already knew about because they were in the beta in terms of data for them. So, yep. Oops.
Meaning they had to go ahead and announce it because it was already out.
Yep.
Way to go.
We got a new mode for Escape Run called Dead Star. Six 2016 games by Adult Swim were spotlighted. Death's Gambit, Duck Game, Rain World, Raise the Dead, Small Radians, Big Televisions, and Double Fine's Headliner.
The only one I've heard of out of all of that is Duck Game.
Yeah, same here. Tim Schafer came out, showed off Day of the Tentacle Remastered trailer, and announced a Full Throttle remaster for PlayStation 4 alongside Psychonauts and the Rhombus of Ruin, a standalone game for PlayStation VR. We got Don't Starve Together coming to PlayStation 4. We also got Zodiac Arcano Odyssey for PlayStation 4 and Vita in terms of a trailer. I was about to say, there's another thing here, but apparently either trailer's later or they didn't put it here, but we also got the announcement of Psychonauts 2. And it's being crowdfunded. Let's see, on December 8th, we got Yakuza 5 coming on PlayStation 3 and Yakuza 0 coming for PlayStation 4. King of Fighters 14 came, got a trailer shown off. I must have said 15, but no, it's 14. We got a debut trailer for Nioh, which I think is the kind of Dark Souls-esque game, except it's more feudal Japan-inspired than medieval-inspired. If I'm remembering that trailer correctly. Yeah. Look kind of interesting. But it definitely looks like it was taking... It's definitely, like, going along the same lines as Dark Souls. See, Bastion's coming for Vita. It was available as soon as it was announced for $2.99. BitTrip 6 game HD package coming for, let's see, cross-buy for $9.99, and the upcoming Nuclear Throne. Additionally, they revealed a trailer for Stormcloud Games' new Brutal, an ASC2-inspired fantasy game. So an old DOS-inspired fantasy game. New trailer from MLB The Show 2016. We got the multiplayer free-to-play strategy game Guns Up shown off. More stuff for the co-op adventure for Fat Princess. Demo shown off for the new Ratchet & Clank game that comes out next year to go inside the movie. And as they put it, it's the game, based off the movie, based off the game. Well, it's true.
True.
It's also technically a reboot of the franchise, but it does look cool. We got a whole bunch of VR shit at this point. We got a Res Infinite VR trailer, a Full Body VR tech demo, Eagle Flight VR trailer, the Modern Zombie Taxi Company VR trailer, which is essentially like one of those simulator-esque comedy games. It's one of those.
Huh.
And we also got Golem, another VR game. We also got another VR game in the form of 100th Robot Golf, which is essentially super robot fighting mixed with actually golfing in giant in cities as a giant robot.
Huh. You know what I'm having a funny feeling?
What?
2016's going to be the year of VR.
Oh, I still don't care about VR.
I think it's cool.
If it had good games to it, I would care. Unfortunately, it doesn't.
Yet.
Well, when it starts having good games, I'll care. Otherwise,
you know,
I'm like,
you know, technically, you can play Keep Talking and Nobody Explodes with VR.
Yes, but I can do that right now without VR.
I think there's also ways to make Minecraft work with VR.
Which I can also play right now without VR.
Yeah, but you're not actually in the game, though.
And? Does it change that much?
Probably not.
Then it's a gimmick that doesn't matter. Anyway, we got a trailer show off Ace Combat 7. We got the announcement of the racing minigame that's being added to Destiny. It's free for anyone who has the Destiny Taken King expansion. And it's going on right now. 3-week long competitive racing event. And also after this, they announced that they're not, this next year, they're not going to do any major DLC packs. They're going to focus more on microtransaction-fueled events. So, little smaller events instead of big, huge expansions. Maybe it'll help, like, keep people interested in the game. Because you do have those huge gaps with the DLC packs of like, hey, we completed the DLC pack stuff, and now it's just kind of the normal daily stuff you do for Destiny and nothing really special from there. We got a trailer for Hob. We got a trailer for Ni No Kuni 2! Reverent Kingdom. PlayStation 4 exclusive. And we closed out with On a New MOBA by Epic Games. And that's it. So, besides Final Fantasy VII, anything else look interesting? Oh, yeah. Wait, was that PlayStation Experience? Okay, yeah. No, that was some other time. I was trying to think of, like, the new Quantic Dream game. But no, that was another time. Because I looked at that trailer, and I'm like, hey, that's that chick from the Quantic Dream trailer. Or the new Quantic Dream game. But anyway, anything besides the Final Fantasy VII Remake gameplay and us talking about the other news that came out about Final Fantasy VII by extension?
Not really seeing anything else that's jumping out, but... Great. I get ad.
To be honest, there's not that much. I'm like, some of the stuff looks neat, but... Eh. It's not really, like, super interesting that me. Like, it'd been cool if we got some Kingdom Hearts 3 news! Like, you know, that fucking trailer that was at the goddamn event that you fucking put behind closed doors for no fucking reason because you're a bunch of fucking assholes who don't want us to be excited for this game, apparently. Because you hiding shit. Ugh. All I want is the trailer. I don't care. Just show the trailer. That's all I want is just the trailer. I want something to be like, hey, Kingdom Hearts 3 is coming at some point in the future. You know, we don't have a release date. We haven't had anything of Kingdom Hearts 3 news and since, what, D23 where they went? Oh, by the way, we're doing like a Big Hero 6 world and that was it. I want something to, like, speculate upon for Kingdom Hearts 3. I want something to, like, dig my teeth into and be excited for about Kingdom Hearts 3, because I know this game ain't gonna come out for 2 years, probably. So I like something to, like, keep my interest. Because I think we've dug up every fucking secret there is in any footage that's out there for Kingdom Hearts 3 right now. Anyway. Shall we take a look at this Final Fantasy VII footage on the terrible IGN player?
I guess we shall on the terrible IGN player.
To be honest, I had no other options in terms of having all of the stuff available.
So you had to pick the terrible IGN player?
Yep.
Let's do it.
Alright, take a look at Final Fantasy VII gameplay in 3, 2, 1, go. I'll tell you this much, it looks really good. Also, I believe that voice sync is a bit off. Just a little bit. Although this does still look like Advent Children, this is like the second time I've seen it. Now we get the gameplay.
This actually looks cool.
Doesn't this look like Final Fantasy 15? Because to me, it looks totally like Final Fantasy 15. And I'm like, oh, so we're essentially using 15 to kind of help make the Final Fantasy 7 remake. Like, apparently they're still utilizing the ATB gauge to a certain extent. So it's not, like, full Final Fantasy XV gameplay. So it's kind of like a mix of that in, like, an old-school Final Fantasy gameplay. But still, it looks like totally like they used Final Fantasy XV to help build this.
They probably did.
Especially, like, those running around the world segments, I'm like, oh yeah, that looks like 15. You're totally using 15 to help make this.
I don't know. It feels on par with, feels kind of on par with 13, also. In terms of some of that stuff.
Yeah, I was about to say, you know people want to burn you for that one, right?
I'm speaking the truth. To this, I also say, even after 13, people still were wanting a 7 remake, and everyone should have known at that point 13 would have been the benchmark. So, not my fault for making that comparison.
Well, still looks good. I know, like, one of the people I watch that streams a lot was saying he didn't like the changes to the battle system. And to be honest, from what they're saying, this is a remake of Final Fantasy VII. They are not beholding themselves wholly to what came before. They are willing to make changes. Whether they be gameplay changes, story changes, any changes. They are not, like, chaining themselves down to be going, yeah, we're gonna totally gonna give you the same Final Fantasy VII game that you can buy right now on, like, any console you want. No, we're not. We're doing what we want to do, which is a second shot at Final Fantasy VII. And bringing Final Fantasy VII up to par with current games.
I just hope by doing this, they don't mess with the story necessarily, because that's going to be where people are going to really critique it. Like, if the battle system's changed, that's going to tick some off, but it's probably not going to be as horrible.
Mm-hmm.
But if you go messing with the story the exact story that everyone knows and loves about Seven. Yeah.
Especially that one character ending up dead, you know.
That's going to be one of those, yeah. I wouldn't want to be them if they do that.
Yep. Yeah, also, Final Fantasy VII will be released as a multi-part release.
Yeah.
They did not specify how, I don't believe. They just said it's going to be released in multiple parts.
So it's going to be episodic.
Yeah, more than likely. That's a lot of what people said, even though that's not what they said. Bear in mind, all Square Enix has said is going to be released in multiple parts. They have not said episodic at all. Those are the words of anyone that's reporting it. That's not Square Enix's words on the matter. So I want to clarify that.
Okay, parting it out, though. That's going to be the exact same thing that we're used to seeing, in the Walking Dead game, in the Minecraft story mode game. Should I keep going, or are we good?
Well, I was going to say, in everything Telltale does, because they're the ones who do all that. Literally the ones who do all those games.
I mean, if they didn't want it to be said like that in all kinds of press, they shouldn't have said it how they said it either.
Yeah. I'm just saying that in case they say something different later on. And then it's like, well, they said it was episodic. And I'm like, no, they didn't. They said it was multi-part. They didn't say it was episodic. We all said it was episodic. Because we are making that interpretation. I just want that line drawn there of like, this is our interpretation of what they said. This is what they said. Just in case they do something different.
In my opinion, that would work. Doing it episodic.
Because, especially if they split it up by disc.
Well, they might could go even a step further. Might. I've not played 7, so I don't know. But I would venture to say that even on each disc, there is a point where you would have a good breaking point. I know 8 was set up like that.
Yeah.
And 7 and 8 share a lot of similarities there.
Probably does. It's just someone who's well-versed in the 7 story might have a better idea how it's split like that.
That's why I'm like, I've not played it, so I'm not saying there is, but they might could go that extra step. And maybe even split up the discs a bit. Because I know from 8, I really know in modern times how 13 was done. One disc can hold a lot of gameplay.
Yeah.
A lot of gameplay.
So yeah, Final Fantasy VII will be split up, and that's about the most interesting thing I think that came out of the PlayStation Experience, to be honest.
And probably the most uproaring.
Mm-hmm.
Because that whole being split into parts kind of really just got under everyone's grill for a bit there.
Well, here's the thing, they didn't announce that at PlayStation Experience. They announced that, like, the day after.
And that's why it got under everyone's grill a bit.
Yep. It's like, hey, here's some cool gameplay! And now we're gonna tell you it's split into parts. And we told you that now, so you didn't boo us off the stage.
You know what's bad? By them saying that, I have a funny feeling a lot of people are thinking, oh, great. So that means I'm going to have to pay $20 for the base game. Then I'm probably going to have to pay $5 to $10 for each additional part. Instead, they need to be thinking, oh, wait, they're actually giving us a completely rebuilt game. It's still going to be $60, but we have the choice of when we want to pay for each part.
Yeah. To be honest, this game looks good. So. Alright. Shall we do one last quick article before we move on to releases and quick draws?
Nope.
Well, we're doing it anyway.
Okay. Yay!
YouTube revealed their most popular video gaming videos of 2015. And I think one of them is a Markiplier video. Let me check. Yep, it is.
the Five Nights 3?
Yeah, the number 5 one.
Yeah, I thought so.
But yeah, your top 10 most popular video game videos. Number 1, Clash of Clans Revenge, the official Super Bowl TV commercial.
Wow.
Number 2, Real GTA. That's at least something creative. Number 3, the original Star Wars Battlefront reveal trailer. I don't remember that trailer. What was that trailer?
I don't remember that trailer.
Oh, that not gameplay trailer. Now I know what that trailer is.
Oh, so that thing that EA loves to do?
Mm-hmm. Number 4, Five Nights 3 teaser trailer. Coming in at number 5, from Marky Mark himself, his first part of Five Nights at Freddy's 3.
You mean Marky Moo. I had to.
Is that legitimately a nickname of his?
Uh-huh.
God damn it! I did Marky Mark as a joke, because that's technically the name of, I can't even think of his name right now. It's an actor. Anyway. Number 6! The trailer or commercial for Pokemon Go? Yeah, I believe it's the original trailer for Pokemon Go. Alrighty then. Coming in at number 7, the official trailer for Fallout 4 from back at E3. I believe it's that trailer.
You mean the one that we've actually
done
multiple times?
Yep, that trailer.
Because we think it's a different trailer every time and we wind up watching it again.
Well, to be fair, that was Glock, not us. Coming in at
number
8. Yeah,
but we didn't catch it either, so I mean, that's just as bad on us.
Yep, coming in at number 8. Elders React Gaming, as they play Grand Theft Auto 5. I've seen a bit of that. That's hilarious. You have a grandmother getting right into the mood of this game.
Oh, wow.
It's not like, oh, this horrible game. No, some of them are enjoying it. It's hilarious. See, here's the thing. Old people are hilarious. That is the thing some people don't realize. Old people are hilarious. Because they're willing to say anything. Coming at number 9, Halo versus Call of Duty. I don't know what this is.
Are we counting originals of both series?
This looks like a fan thing, I believe.
Well, the reason why I say that is if not, then that's up for debate.
And finally, coming in at number 10, the original Final Fantasy VII release trailer from E3 this year. The hypest of the hype trailers. That said, yep, Final Fantasy VII, the remake. Moving on. So yeah, that is your top 10 video game videos on YouTube this year. You know what? I'll give credit. Marky Mark somehow managed to make it. Or as you say, Marky Moo.
Other people say it.
Well, as you brought up, Marky Moo is the only video game YouTuber, I think, to make this list. Because I think everyone else is more of your animation comedy group guys. He's the only Let's Player out of this bunch.
Well, someone's got to do it.
Attaboy, Marky Moo. You made it halfway up the list. With Five Nights 3.
That's farther
just
than PewDiePie did.
Just Five Nights 3 teaser trailer.
You know it?
What?
That's farther than PewDiePie did.
You're right! Suck it, PewDiePie! Yes! Somebody one up the pubes. That's something Matt calls him all the time. Whenever he has to refer to him, he calls him that. Anyway, here's our release list going forward, literally till the first of the year. By the way, half these releases are PC, literally.
Half? Really? Uh-huh. Just half?
Uh-huh.
You sure not most?
No, it's about half. Because it's literally it doubled the list by the time I got done.
Jeez.
So starting this, I believe Tuesday. Nope, this Monday on the 14th, one day before the Smash Direct. Excuse me. We have Abaris 2, The Return of the Empress on PC. Balrum for PC. Dead Star for PC. Dragon Path for PC. Quantum Lock for PC. And Star Nomad 2 for PC. Coming out this Tuesday, when the Smash Direct goes down, it's King's Quest 2. Or King's Quest Chapter 2. Rubble Without a Cause for 360, Xbox One, PlayStation 3, PlayStation 4, and PC. I need to take a drink here real quick.
Okay.
Alright. Tony Hawk's Pro Skater 5 for 360. Minecraft Wii U Edition on the Wii U, if it's not obvious already.
Oh, I thought it was coming out on the 3DS.
Sure. Colonial Assault for PC. Giga Chess for PC. It's not just chess. It's Giga Chess.
Is that like Giga Bowser, but chess form?
You know what? I'm willing to look.
I had to say it. You know, that's something I just thought about. You can't make a Giga Bowser in Mario Maker. It would have been cool if they'd done that.
It's a puzzle game? Kind of? It's just... Alright.
Well then.
Hatfield Boyfriend! Holiday Star! I forgot the R there for PC. Rubber Ducky and the Rainbow Gun for
you
PC.
One.
Oh, did I?
Yeah.
Oh, Micro RC Simulation for PC. Yeah, don't ask me about Rubber Ducky. That is a thing. Squad for PC. Turnover for PC.
Cloud for Smash 4. Oh.
Yep, that too. Along with whatever the fuck else they're going to release that day, because God knows they're going to release a whole bunch of other shit that day. Coming out on the 16th, we got Final Fantasy 6, I believe? Yep, 6 for PC. Goblins and Grottos for PC. Coming out on the 17th, we have Legend of the Dark Witch 2 for 3DS. Coming out on the 18th, you have Pro Skater 5 coming out on PS3. Goodnight Butcher for PC and The Fall of Gods on PC. Coming out on the 21st, you have Unsummoning the Spectral Horde for PC. On the 22nd, you have Legend of Heroes, Trails of Cold Steel for PS3 and Vita. And then you have Hatfield Boyfriend, Holiday Star with the R this time, because apparently I corrected it, even though I copy-pasted two there to begin with, I think. Yeah, I believe I copy-pasted down there, so I apparently added the R in the process. Or that, or I forgot the R when I copied up there, I don't fucking know. PlayStation 4 and Vita. On the 23rd, we have Frizzy for Xbox One, and finally, on the next time we're going to be streaming here for TGS, on the 1st of January of the new year, it's Police Infinity for PC.
As long as it's not like Disney Infinity, then we're good.
Yep.
Boy, I'm just in a crap on other games mood right now.
Well, to be fair, I'm always in the mood to crap on Disney Infinity. I love shitting on Disney Infinity.
Yeah, but I've just been going ham on it today.
Well, sometimes they just deserve it. Anyway. We got quick draws to go through, and mine goes to that new shelf I built with all my Rider figure arts.
That one.
Yep. Which, By the way, you can see the cluttered togetherness of my amiibos right now because that shelf doesn't quite fit the risers like I wanted it to. So I'm kind of using that to display all my amiibos, and I'm kind of out of room on them. Meaning I'm gonna have to build something else and find out what to do with these risers now that I have them. Anyway. Yep. I have it set up to where this main top shelf, this nice big shelf, is for my main and secondary riders. I might have something a little bit bigger than the two pieces of wood there to display it with. Got a shelf below that for all the final forms I have. Got a shelf below that for all my extra figures, which is just the Solo Rider, Cyclone, and Joker, plus Skull, plus Protobirth, plus Nadeshko. And two shelves of bikes. Right now I only have the Kuga's Beat Chaser and Beat Gorum. And then an entire shelf for boxes, which I'm already running out of room on that.
Yeah, I can see that.
Yeah, that's completely full of boxes. Huh. So yeah, brand new shelf. Me and my dad built it over Thanksgiving break. And my room still smells of fresh wood. So, yeah.
That's a good smell.
Yes, it is. I actually like that smell. Even though I think it fucks with my sinuses.
Well, then that's not good.
It's not bad. I think it just messes with me. But I do like the smell of fresh wood. Yeah. Also, I've ordered for myself Agito, which will be going in that oddly placed space right there between Kuga and Wizard. Yeah, Agito's going right there so I can actually fill in that hole. And I'll probably be rearranging people after Agito and Mach come in, because Mach should be coming in before Christmas. Because I placed the order for him on Mandarake, and I'll probably get the pay order, or the pay link, probably overnight. Also, I'm thinking of trying to find some lighting for this, since, yeah, you see how everything's, like, half in shadow.
Yeah. You know what you gotta do?
What?
Get you some of them LED strips run along the back of it.
That's what I was thinking, is getting some battery-powered LED strips. Just so there's some light in there. Because, like, the top shelf, no problem. Every other shelf, yeah, it's kind of a problem.
Yeah.
Yeah, I just have to find, like, the right LED strips. I might take a trip to, like, Home Depot and Lowe's and see if I can find some there. Because looking online, I'm like, I don't know. Maybe I should just see the stuff in person.
That might be the best thing. Try to find some that you can find here, and then if you can find the same ones online cheaper, then yeah.
Well, the thing, the places I was looking was Lowe's and Home Depot.
Oh. I know there's some on eBay. There's some sellers that sell them. But yeah, I agree with you. I would look at them. And then go from there.
What the fuck?
What?
At the League of Legends All-Star event, there is a giant TV that has a giant picture of Teemo, and underneath it says, "Stomp to get rid of Teemo."
Oh, God.
The fuck is going on? Literally, what the fuck is going on? I don't even know anymore. Anyway, that's my quick draw. So, Tommy, fire away.
Well, I guess I'm going to get to shoot the gun then. Anyhow, mine is going out to what will more than likely by the end of the weekend, unless I just get off on other stuff, like editing videos, you know, like the thing that I'm supposed to do.
Yeah.
That I've been kind of not doing all week. Even though I should have been getting next week's going, but yeah. but this is the currently the Tumblr page, but It will more than likely be replacing the homepage. However, the forums that we use for the site will still exist and all that. So, yeah. But the only thing that might slow up this is I don't know how I'm wanting to implement the blogs into it. I've tossed ideas around, but nothing's been sticking. So.
Ow. I was gonna say, you could probably just do it as regular posts.
That's probably what we're going to have to do, and then just have, like, set tags.
Mm-hmm. Well, I already have set tags for all my block stuff anyway.
Well, I mean, in, like, for each of our names. That way I can have it sorted by that.
Okay. That'd be easy enough, because I just add that in.
But, yeah. And as you all see, I've got the SWTOR episode that went out today in there.
Yeah, that one. Were we just about?
Go ahead.
I was about to say that's the episode where we finished up all the Alderaan stuff. And I think we're about to finish up chapter one of our characters.
Oh,
I
wow.
Think.
Oh,
wow. I think chapter one ends off right around there.
But
we should be near that. If we're getting like a super solo instance, like that should be the end.
Huh.
The only thing I have to judge off is my Smuggler 1. The problem is it's been a long time since I was done with chapter 1 of Smuggler.
True. But hopefully with this, we can start posting it. All of the different videos that go up as it's going.
Yeah.
Hopefully.
I also
get to do it.
Yeah, I also realized today I forgot to post the article for TGS from 2 weeks ago.
Whoops.
Yeah, and I was like, well, it's a little late to do it now. I might as well do it after the next one goes up.
But yeah, we should be switching to this, but the old stuff, I do have links, as you see there, old news, all blogs, that will link back to all of the stuff we already have posted. So none of that stuff will disappear. It's just, it'll be in a different spot. I honestly kind of like this layout better, in my opinion.
Yeah.
It kind of strips it back down and gives better links to stuff.
Yeah, it also allows us to embed videos.
Yes.
Which is fantastic, because then we don't have to link friggin' every video and being like, oh yeah, you have to go to YouTube to watch the video, you can't watch it on the website. Otherwise, we kind of break things.
Yeah.
Like, we super break things, because the run... How to describe this? It's not really stability, but the load times for the site increase dramatically when we start embedding everything.
And I think Tumblr is going to be a lot more stable in terms of that.
Yeah.
Not to mention another reason I'm kind of wanting to switch over. The way it currently is, you have to make an account for the site.
Uh-huh.
This way, if you already have a Tumblr account, which a lot of people do, you ain't got to worry about that.
Yeah. Well, I think Tumblr right now is like the predominant social media site. I want to say, like, more so than Twitter, I feel like.
I don't know. It's at least up there.
Well, I feel like I, more often than not, even though I don't have a dedicated program that gives me Twitter updates, I go to Tumblr more often than Twitter.
Makes sense.
But yeah.
But yeah, that's mine anyhow. Everyone will know if it's live if this gets posted on it or not.
But you'll have to tell me, because I'm the one who does the posting.
Yeah.
For that.
Yeah. Like, I think it's at the point where I could just say, yeah, we'll do that, but
mm-hmm.
There's some back-end stuff I've got to do before it's ready, technically.
Okay.
So, yeah.
So, in what, 3 weeks? Yep, 3 weeks. Not 2 weeks, 3 weeks.
Yes, 3 weeks.
In 3 weeks, we'll be back with TGS and talking about end of the year stuff, really. Probably what's going to be most of the show is just us talking about end of the year stuff. Kind of looking back at this whole year of 2015 in gaming and reminiscing. And that will probably be it, because I doubt anything big outside of the Smash Direct will be happen. And we'll be covering the Smash Direct in more than likely a separate thing that will go out, like, Tuesday. Because I'm more than willing to go. I'm going to just say, hey, I'm going to hit the record button. I'm going to have a backdrop up on OBS, and we're just going to talk until we're done.
That would work.
Yeah. Of course, that requires me to install Photoshop to have a special background for that. So, anyway. Until either one of those things, or whenever you next watch a video for TGS, or next catch a live stream from us, if you're watching live right now, that'll do it for Tommy and for me. And we'll see you next time on whatever you watch from the Gaming Saloon, including this show. I was going somewhere with that, and then I fucked up.
Yeah, I kind of figured.
Anyway, bye.
As always, you can find the Gaming Saloon on our site at tgsnetwork.org. Don't forget to follow us on our social medias, on Twitter by following at TGSaloon, on Google Plus at google.com/plus TGS TGSR.org, and on YouTube at youtube.com/TGSaloon. Till next time.